Hello, this is Jeff Brueggemann with
Kevin Lee.
Ru-Shiun Liou.
We are covering BA 104 Global Business, trying to redesign this class.
Well, I'm going to talk about the current state. Jeff and I have taught BA 104 over the last few semesters, and currently we primarily focus on lecture-based teaching where we go through a textbook. We lecture to our students and we give them exams. It's not very satisfactory for us and definitely not very engaging for our students. Therefore, we've decided using this summer program to try to redesign our course.
Some of the things we'd like to do is build consistency across the sessions. Since I have had night classes and there are other classes that are during the day. Plus, we have the BA 104 and the 174, the BA 104 being the DE class. We would like to try to align the activities so that each of the courses are doing the same thing. I will add a couple of things, and we will change the scoring as well on the grading.
Yeah. Ultimately, what we really want is to get engagement, engagement, engagement out of our students. As far as the redesign action plan, one of the things we learned, surprisingly, was that there actually was a learning outcome included in our GEs. Because it's a GE class, obviously, it's kind of important that we at least address the learning outcomes within the GE. So we have incorporated that into our new program. We have also made some changes in our activities. We've included additional activities for students. And we've changed our grading scheme so that the grading isn't so top-heavy on just memorization on exams. We've also included brainstorming activities to try to get our students to have engaged learning. And something that was really important that Jeff kept bringing up was this idea of incorporating real-world expertise by incorporating Skype and bringing in guest speakers from around the world. Here is a list of the GE programs outcomes that are now part of our learning outcomes. You can go ahead and take a moment and read this, but ultimately what it looks at is it looks at giving our students a broad exposure to cultures and ethnicities and relationships between such. This is important because really for most students, this class will be the only class that they take within this GE category. Our learning outcomes for the course, just to briefly go over, is to differentiate systems of economic and politics in global business, examine alternative global business strategies and structures, recognize and understand various forms of global business. Now, one of the things that my colleague Ru-Shiun was able to do was she was able to map out for us some of our key components of our program and how it mapped out into the learning outcomes. So as we can see, two of our major requirements is we require a cultural interview assignment, which will be new for Jeff. Yep. And we are also including our country project, and we're streamlining this, which is something that has worked in the past and we've had it, but now we think we're going to make it even better. And you can see where it crosses over and matches up with some of the learning outcomes. We are, of course, still doing exams and quizzes, which are based on the textbook, but we are lowering the weight down to 50%, and in the future, we might lower it even more.
So I'd like to talk about the highlight of our course redesign, which is about the cultural interview assignment, and which Jeff hasn't done before, but Kevin and I had a little bit of experience about this assignment. Basically, we want the students to go out and interview somebody who has a very different cultural background from them, and then they will summarize the interview based on their observations of a similarity as well as the differences across two different cultures. And then in the end, they need to generate a reflection report about the difference and the similarity. And then at the very end, we want them to reflect and think about how they and offer recommendations in terms of in the future when they overcome, when they need to overcome the cultural differences and when they have the encounter with the person from that cultural background. And what we've been very benefited from this academy section is about bioteams experiencing peer review grading systems. And so we actually want to implement this part, this important component in this assignment as well, because we want to have a partial grade based on their peer reviews. And we've been talking about how we will assign a part of the grade based on their own reviews and as well as their quality of their reviews on other people's interview summaries. And would you like to talk more about that?
Yeah, we figured this is also a way for the students to have to read other cultural interviews. Because if somebody is interviewing somebody from a different culture, well, they have exposure to one culture. But now if they have to peer review other papers by other students, more than likely they're going to be reading about different cultures as well. And we think this is consistent with the learning outcome requirements for the GE, so we think this will work out well.
Definitely will broaden their scope of understanding of different cultures.
Right.
Yeah, I agree.
And then another important goal for us is to increase the students' engagement. And one of the cool media tools we learned through the sessions was about making videos. And so I made a video about how we can encourage students' engagement by offering an alternative way to present their cultural interview summary, which is by making a video. And now I want to show you this video clip.
Now, one of our biggest challenges, I think, is the assessment. You know, how well is our coursework design actually going to work for us? And I guess what we wanted to do is we didn't want to reinvent the wheel. So we decided to use this assessment model that was presented to us already by Chris Hernandez in our presentations. And we're going to use that as our platform and then make adjustments as we see fit and try to follow this timeline assessment to see if there's actual positive impact on the students. Well, we would like to thank the Summer Academy for giving us this opportunity to really come together and giving us the time to really work out our plans for our course. We think our courses will be better. In addition, we also learned quite a bit of stuff, especially about technology that we didn't know about or we might have been somewhat intimidated about in the past. And these are things that we may or may not incorporate in this program, but I already know that there are other classes that I teach that I may want to incorporate different things into, so I've learned quite a bit. Now, besides all of that, as far as the redesign layout, what we are planning to do is do a pilot program this next semester in the fall. Jeff will teach day 104, and Ru-Shiun will teach VA 174. Now, these two classes are slightly different. However, we can incorporate most of the redesign changes into both classes, and we will use it as a pilot. And depending on the feedback we get and, you know, what we experience, we will make some fine-tuning adjustments for the following semester. Any concerns?
I think some of the concerns that we may have is making sure that the students are technology savvy and able to handle this, because we do have such a broad array of students with cultural, ethnic,
economic
backgrounds. A lot of foreign students in the class, usually various majors. So some are extremely technology savvy and some are not. This could be a problem in the course, but I think that by being flexible, we'll be able to handle that.
And in addition to add what Kevin just mentioned, we learned a lot of the cool ideas how, in terms of how to flip the classroom. And personally, I feel I would like to try out the iClickers in the classes that I'm going to teach in the fall. And in the past, that I have groups to evaluate each other's group presentation. And but I only use a paper format. So in the end, I end up with a pile of papers and I need to sort through in my office, and then I create a lot of administration work for myself. So by using iClickers, I think I will be able to manage that workload in a reasonable manner.
Once again, our group, the Global Business Group, would like to thank the Summer Academy. I'd like to thank Sea Salt and Tilt for their invaluable help. Once again, thank you and have a great summer, guys. Bye.
Thank you.